Hey everybody, it's Crappie Dan. Tip of the month, I want to talk about loading line on a new reel. When it comes in a package like this new B&M reel, this is what we use on our trolling poles, our jigging poles for crappie. As you can see, this is a BAN02. What I like to do with these reels is take them right out of the package like you see here. This is how they come. And when I get it out of the package, I then will load it into my line winder, which will allow me to load the line on the reel. The real key thing that I want to help you with for everybody that's a beginner out there, when these come out of the package, this is your, shall we say, your drag for the reel. When you tighten this down, you will have no drag on that reel. And as you can see, I've been feeding line on this particular reel. A couple of key points are, make sure that this is tightened down, not extremely tight, just to the touch tight, so that the line won't come back off the reel when you're loading it on the reel. I've got a line winder. This here is a Bass Pro Shops line winder to feed the line onto the reel. The key thing about what direction should you put the line on the reel? Well, as you can see, this is not exactly how it will look on the rod. I've got a rod base over here. I want to show you. This is the rod base. This is how the reel will fit on that rod base. If you are a right-hander, you'll probably want this reel to be loaded where the handle is over here on the right-hand side where my finger is pointing. So if that's the case, you always have to reverse it when you're putting it on your line feed in order to put the line on the reel so that it'll come off of the reel properly onto the rod. So reverse it when you're putting it on here. As you can see, this is exactly how you would put your reel on here. And when you feed the line on, you will rotate it clockwise, just like you see here, with it reversed on the opposite side. Just clockwise like you see here, and then it will be all good. Now, as you can see, this is feeding correctly onto the reel. And once you're completed, you'll pull it off of here. What I like to do when I'm loading them up, I'm putting the line on these, I have a good workbench, I put it on. Make sure when you load it up on the reel, you see these little openings inside the reel casing. Load it to the base of that particular opening. That way then you don't have too much line on the reel so it won't come flying off the reel. Also, make sure when you're loading it off of this spool that I showed you earlier, it's coming off of that spool and coming the same direction onto this spool. That way the line will have the right curvature on the reel. A couple of tips so that you can put the line on your new reel. You can go out and feed it on your new rod. You'll be set to go to get some fish. Take care. This is Dan Dannemuehler. Till next time, catch some big crappie.